Hello friends, I'll be explaining about the Refsum disease. So Refsum disease is a metabolic error which occurs due to the lack of enzyme alpha hydroxylase. So it is a metabolic error. This question is very important, ask for 5 marks or it might be a sub question in 10 mark question. So it is a metabolic error. So why is it occurring? It occurs due to the lack of enzyme alpha hydroxylase. So there is lack of enzyme. What is its name? Alpha hydroxylase. So there will be lack of the enzyme alpha hydroxylase. So in this kind of disease, what happens in the sense, there will be absence of alpha oxidation in our body. So we have alpha oxidation process taking place in our body and the alpha oxidation requires this enzyme, but this enzyme is absent. So alpha oxidation will not take place in our body and there will be accumulation of a special acid called as phytanic acid. So what happens in the sense, alpha oxidation does not occur in our body and leads to accumulation of what was its name? Phytanic acid, phytanic acid. So it leads to the accumulation of the phytanic acid. So usually they say this phytanic acids are found more in milk and milk products. So those who have Refsum disease should avoid milk. Remember this point, it is more in milk. So avoid milk. So it is more in milk, so avoid milk. So what are the symptoms found in this Refsum disease? So remember, there are 4 symptoms which you have to remember and the hint is PCRN. Okay, it's PCRN. First one is polyneuropathy. Second one is cerebellar ataxia. There will be problems occurring in the cerebellum, ataxia. Third one, R, P is over, C is over, R is for retinitis pigmentosa. So here what are in the retinitis pigmentosa, there will be damage in the retina of our eye. So retinal damage will be there, retina is damaged. Retina will be damaged in the Refsum disease. Last one, not the least, N stands for nerve deafness. So these are the 4 main symptoms occurring in the Refsum disease: polyneuropathy, cerebellar ataxia, retinitis pigmentosa, which means retinal damage, as well as the nerve deafness. PCRN. So there is another thing have to remember is infantile Refsum disease. So if the Refsum disease occurs in the infants, it is called as infantile Refsum disease. So what happens in the sense, it is a peroxisomal disorder. So it is a peroxisomal disorder. What happened this in the sense, in the Refsum disease, there is accumulation of only phytanic acid. But in infants, there will be accumulation of phytanic acid as well as VLCFA. It means very long chain fatty acids. So, accumulation of phytanic acid plus very long chain fatty acids. It is also called as VLCFA. So, accumulation of phytanic acid plus there will be accumulation of very long chain fatty acids. It is infantile Refsum disease is somewhat similar to the Zellweger syndrome. So, you might be knowing about this. So, Zellweger syndrome. It is somewhat similar to Zellweger's syndrome. So, this is all about the Refsum disease. It is a Refsum disease is a metabolic error which occurs due to the lack of enzyme alpha hydroxylase. Alpha oxidation is not taking place, so there will be accumulation of the phytanic acid since this agent is enzyme. So what happens in phytanic acid? There will be four symptoms which is visible: polyneuropathy, cerebellar ataxia, nerve deafness, as well as retinitis pigmentosa PCRN. So those who have Refsum disease, M, remember it as M, they should avoid milk. They should avoid milk and milk products. D for dairy products. Then infantile Refsum disease, it is a peroxisomal disorder. What happens in this sense? There will be accumulation of phytanic acid along with the VLCFA, that is very long chain fatty acids. It is somewhat similar to Zellweger's syndrome. Infantile Refsum disease symptoms are so same as the Refsum disease. So hope you like my video. Please like, share, comment and subscribe. Thank you.